A video from the Afghan TV press conference shows a reporter who appears to be in a bit of a hostage situation. And honestly, my question is, why did the Taliban think it was a good idea to appear in the video the way that they did, as they're trying to convince, you know, everyone across the planet that they're changed and they totally believe in giving people rights? I don't know. Let's watch.
به نام خدا و عرض سلام و درود بر شما بیننده های شبکه جهانی افغانستان به ویژه برنامه پرداز باز هم شما را خوش آمدید میگویم. میرویس حیدری حق دوست هستم شما را دعوت میکنم تا پایان این برنامه با ما همراه باشین. حالا که نظام اشرف غنی سقوط کرده و آقای غنی از افغانستان فرار کرده و در افغانستان ایده ای که منتقد اشرف غنی هستند میگویند که رئیس جمهور فراری و مردم تنها گذاشت و خودشان رفتند و حالا امارت اسلامی.
So again, that was during a Afghan TV press conference, and the reporter or the journalist there is telling people that they shouldn't be afraid of the Taliban. Apparently, their preferred name is Islamic Emirate. I'm going to keep calling them the Taliban, and that they should cooperate and not be afraid. So look, I don't really have much to say about this. The Taliban's awful. Right? I know it, you know it, the American people know it. But if they're trying to launder their reputation and pretend like they want to give people rights, I mean, they could be off camera holding their weapons, right? Because of course they're going to hold the guy hostage. But like, why did they think it was, like, they're so dumb.
Yeah. So I have a couple things to say about this. One is that I was genuinely curious if they were so unaware of everything else in the world, because everybody lives in their own bubble and it's apparently impossible to escape your own perspective. And so if they thought, oh, this is good PR, like we'll tell everybody, we'll make the anchor say to everybody that you're safe while having two lunatics behind them. Look at their eyes. Like, what's wrong with their eyes?
I don't know.
Right? There's nothing wrong with it. It's not an Afghan thing. I mean, the presenter's perfectly fine. These guys like wig out on their eyes for a while. Let's have them with guns on the screen telling everybody that it, or did they mean it? Did they like wink, wink, ha ha, everybody's safe. You better do what we're gonna say, otherwise we're gonna kill you. It's not beyond the Taliban, that's Taliban 101.
Yep.
So I don't know that we're ever gonna get the answer to that, but I am genuinely curious if there was someone who intended it or afterwards they're like, oh, look at that. Nobody could have seen that coming. They thought that they're less safe because of that, huh?
Right? No, I know. I actually think it's the latter. Because I'll give you an example of something else that they did. You know, one of the headlines today was Taliban says that they will allow women to study at universities, right? But they don't allow women to be in the same room as men, meaning that women would have to be segregated in classes without men. Okay. But that, by the way, includes the educator. The professors have to be women as well. Like, but there are no like female professors in Afghanistan under the system, right? So in effect, women are not able to get an education in Afghanistan, right? Mm. So they care about the PR. They care about, you know, making it appear as though like, no, 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 we're totally different now. We're the new and improved Taliban. But come on, like we all know what the truth is. Now, does that mean that we keep boots on the ground and continue on with this forever war that has been a complete and utter disaster? No, all we've done is empower the Taliban with more weaponry. I mean, there's this list going around the internet right now that includes all of the sophisticated military weaponry that we gave to the Afghan military, the now defunct Afghan military, which then ended up in the Taliban's hands. And by the way, initially, the United States created the Taliban by, you know, fighting the Soviets when they had occupied Afghanistan. And so, like anyone who's like, "Oh, the Taliban's so evil, we need to stay there," don't listen to them because they don't actually care about doing anything about the Taliban. We've been there for 20 years and we failed miserably in propping up a government. But at the same time, let's just be clear. Taliban is not good and they're not new and improved in any way.
Yeah, so I think there's a second point I want to make here. So our media is just better at marketing. So now when they hear me say that, they'll be outraged. What do you mean? We don't have people with guns staying behind us. Well, you do bring on former generals who are defense contractors and they have much bigger
weapons.
Come on,
Cenk.
No, I'm serious.
I know, but doing that comparison is ridiculous.
It's not at all ridiculous. Those guys that go on MSNBC and CNN,
I know,
create much more violence
hostage
than the Taliban.
They're not holding people hostage.
Well, the way that they do hold people, our news media hostage, is they give them millions of dollars in advertising. And then they say, by the way, and they say, no, hold on.
Okay.
Hold on. They say, if you don't support wars, we're going to withdraw that money from you. So that's a smarter, more subtle, better marketing way of causing much greater violence. So, hey, we'll just bribe you to do it. And our weapons are way bigger than the Taliban's weapons. And we'll invade Iraq, we'll invade, based on all those generals and all those defense contractors that are all over television. And we'll tell you 20 years of occupation of Afghanistan was wonderful, leaving was terrible. But we're smarter. So our generals wear crisp suits and they come in and they go, they never tell you about the $1 million that they're getting from defense contractors. And they never tell you any of that. And they start much bigger wars with much bigger violence. So yeah, maybe the Morning Joe and Jake Tapper don't have thugs with guns standing behind them. But they bring in thugs who started much bigger wars. And they don't tell you that they're getting paid by defense contractors. And they lie to you on purpose. And they market for more and more wars. So it doesn't make the Taliban better. It makes us, at least we should question ourselves as to how our media operates. And who holds the proverbial gun to their heads. Which is, in this case, not a violent one. But one that has a financial trigger. Either Lockheed Martin and Boeing and Raytheon advertise with you or they don't. So shut up, Jake, and tell everybody how great war is. And have my boy on here to tell people how great war is. So give us credit, we're more sophisticated. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.